WDSU First Warning Weather. We've had our own fair share of localized and short-term flooding, flash flooding, today, yesterday. And we tried to develop some storms after a first round this afternoon. I want to show you what's going to happen after we get through what's going on right now. There is a happening going on. Bastille Day Fête, it is happening there in the Lower Garden District. It's pretty hot at the onset of this. You still got a couple hours to catch this as it wraps up at 10 o'clock tonight. So you wouldn't expect much in the way of rain, but you better be prepared for the heat that's there. And going on to Doppler radar, we've got a couple, one last gasp of a storm, and I was just showing you behind me the skyline that looked like we were trying to develop this storm, and we have been. It's right off Lake Bourne a little earlier, last gasp of a lake breeze there. Lake breeze interacting, developed showers and storms right over town. You can see it's been Araby Chalmette, lower ninth ward, that's gotten a little bit of rain out of it. Now, I have seen a little bit of rain going into the North Shore, too, so let's check you out. We've got a few isolated showers and not really thunderstorms just yet. Some of these moving in west off outflow boundaries. You can see Roseland near Tangipahoa. You've got the heftiest shower that's there, but can't forget about we've got some storms across the border too. So there's still a couple of showers, still a couple of storms that are there, but for the most part, we're really starting to ramp things up in our particular forecast. It's going to be about the heat coming in this weekend. The heat's already here. I mean, we've already had our bouts of heat alerts and heat advisories, excessive heat warnings this season, but another wave set to come. 92. These are current temperatures. Lakefront here, 91 Bogalusa, state's capital. Factoring humidity, feeling like 102 and 106 here in New Orleans and even Lakeside. Let's go and take a look at the big features, if there are any coming our way. Still leftover fronts draped right over the area. That's our heat advisory. But the big dome of the heat, that is set to be moving our way. Nope, you're not going to get anything out of that weak front that's set to be north. We've just got these little systems, the ordinary average July forecast, where afternoon heat of day storms are going to go with the heat that's only going to ramp up this weekend. So the key takeaways here, how much rain we get, and how hot is it going to be? We'll get to the tropics in just a second. Still Doppler radar, there hasn't really been any short-term data that shows any good outlook to where they're headed. So it was kind of a short hit and miss. I'll show you the storms mainly fade away as we get to 8 o'clock tonight. 75 North Shore, 76 to 82 South Shore to get up and going to kick off the weekend. I think fewer storms tomorrow. I know that looks like a little bit of coverage. It's pretty good. I'm only going to give it about a 30-40% chance of storms. A big one forecast here around the Pearl River between Bogalusa, Slidell, and Poplarville. But I think fewer storms than they develop in the afternoon, not late morning, gets us to 94 tomorrow, but factor in humidity, we're talking 108 to 112 is what it could feel like. That'll be an impact day because we've got a heat advisory that kicks in. 11 in the morning goes till 7 at night, making it feel as hot as 112 as we showed. Hey, running the Bulls Saturday, the thing is you get this event in before we get to that heat advisory there. Gallier Hall is where we start. Sunday, I do believe we're going to have more widely scattered storms. I'll give this about a 40% chance, but the heat ticks up another notch. We're to mid-90s, 95 New Orleans, 90 along the coast. You're not quite as hot, but we could be pushing excessive heat warning criteria, but at least it'll be an impact day. This might be the best news that we've got. A number of tropical waves we are still tracking as we go to that tropical connection, but the National Hurricane Center has been watching that broad area of low pressure that maybe there was a 10% chance of development. What they've done is taken it down to a near 0% chance. In fact, with the latest update that just came in from the National Hurricane Center right now, they just took every little bit of chance, not even identifying the area of low pressure. What I'm getting to is nothing being forecast in the Atlantic the next 7 days. And even better news, nothing in the Gulf or Caribbean is expected over the next 7 days as well. What you should prepare for is the heat this weekend, continuing into next week, so another long stretch of it. A few storms possible this weekend, so be prepared to move indoors or get in shelter for a little bit, but the likeliest rain by the end of next week.